Hey, what's up? Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV, coming straight from China to get my hands-on experience on the new Huawei P60 Pro and also the Huawei Mate X3. So keep watching. Now, starting from the Huawei Mate X3, it is the fifth generation of the large foldable smartphones from Huawei, and it is the world's slimmest large screen foldable smartphone, weighing at only 239 grams. So yes, it is lighter than most phones out there, and it's only at 5.3mm, which is barely even thicker than the slim Huawei P60 Pro, which I'll go into detail a little later in this video. Then the Type-C component is the slimmest ever on any foldable. It is also symmetrical and has a classic design that looks really great in the hand. Now the Mate X3 also has a satin and a sheen finish that feels great to touch as well, and is the industry's first quad-curve foldable design, which means that it has an even natural fit for your hands and also an extremely comfortable grip. Now, it's not all about the looks, because when it comes to foldables, it's all about what's inside of the phone. Because this Mate X3 has the next generation multi-dimension hinge that is like a bodyguard for your phone's hinge. So it ensures a top-notch condition no matter how many times that you fold it and unfold it, as it provides a durable and stable flex top. And the best part is that the Huawei Mate X3 has a wet control, which means that not only you'll be able to navigate it if your hands are wet, but also it has an IPX8 rating as well, so you don't have to worry about getting it wet. Next, let's talk about the display, or the displays. Unfolded, it has a 7.85-inch X-True OLED display with a 120Hz refresh rate, 1000 nits of brightness, and a whopping 426 ppi, so you won't be able to take your eyes off it. Then there's an anti-reflective coating that ensures you won't be blinded by the sun's light or any light glare coming from the phone's unfolded screen, and is also 4 times more durable than the previous models. Now, when you fold the phone, you get a 6.4-inch OLED display and a 120Hz refresh rate as well. And don't worry about babying this phone, because it also has the brand new Kunlun glass, also equipped for the cover screen as well. So it can handle up to 10 times drops compared to other smartphones, and as for now, more durable than other foldable smartphones. Then both displays has the TUV Rheinland color accuracy certification. In fact, the display looks like it's painted on the screen. Then looking at the camera specs, there's a 50MP f1.8 aperture lens, a 30MP f2.2 aperture ultra-wide lens, and a 12MP 3.4 telephoto lens. Then as for the front camera, when unfolded, it has an 8MP f2.4 aperture lens, and the folded front camera is also an 8MP f2.4 aperture lens as well. So no matter which screen that you use, whether or not it's inside or even outside at the cover screen, you will get the best selfie images. Then both the rear and the front camera records up to 4K resolution, and it uses the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. Now, as for the RAM and the storage specs, it comes with a massive 12GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Plus, it also has Huawei's proprietary nano SD card storage support, where it supports to another 256GB of storage. It also has a 4,800mAh of battery capacity with 66W of wired charging, 50W of wireless, and 7.5W reverse wireless charging for other devices. And this phone runs on EMUI 13.1, which is Huawei's latest and greatest operating system. Now, when it comes to the colors available, it either comes with this black feather sand glass or the dark green slim vegan leather, both equally as stylish and sleek. Now, I know what you might be thinking, it's only going to be releasing in China, right? Not in Malaysia or globally. Well, the good news is that it will be coming to Malaysia, where I'll be keeping you updated right here in the channel as soon as I get the exact launch details. But that's not all, because the Lighthouse app will also be available in this particular phone when it reaches in Malaysia, which means there will be Google apps in the phone right here as well. Alright, so now moving over to the new Huawei P60 Pro. Now, before diving into the build quality, can we take a moment to just really appreciate the phone's finish? I mean, seriously, this Rococo Pearl has a natural material pearl texture design that is unique to every variant. So you won't have two P60 Pros looking the same. And that is what makes it so special, because it's like a work of art that you can put it in your pocket. Now, what's even sweeter is that the finish isn't just on the body, but also on the camera bump area. And don't get me started by the amazing matte white finish on the phone, because yes, it does not attract any fingerprints at all. But if you're not a big fan of this kind of pearl finish, there's also the very unique looking black color finish, where it looks like a James Bond finish, where you can see in this particular clip over here. And what's unique is that although the screen design is curved, but it's not as slippery as other phones like the Xiaomi 13 Pro, thanks to the quad curve shape of the screen, and it also has an IP68 water and dust resistant. Now, speaking of this particular screen, it has a 6.67 inch display, which is an OLED display with a resolution of 2700 by 1220 pixels and a 120Hz refresh rate LTPO panel. And because it's an LTPO panel, which means that it will go adaptively when it comes to the refresh rate from 1 to 120Hz, so you can save your battery on a smartphone which has always been the king of batteries. And let me just say that based on my first impressions, the display on the phone has been truly amazing. It is super color accurate thanks to its P3 white color gamut, and it also has Huawei's X-True display, which helps to balance out the highlights and the shadows of the screen. Then it's also even TUI Rainland certified, which means that you can trust that your eyes are in good hands when using the phone. Then, like the other newly introduced siblings, it also has the Kunlun glass protection, and this time around it has the quad curve Kunlun glass to help boost the drop resistance up to 10 times. Now, since this is a P-series smartphone from Huawei, which means that the cameras are truly the main focus. So the phone has a main 48 megapixel f1.4 to f4.0 variable aperture lens with OIS, a 48 megapixel f2.1 aperture telephoto lens up to 3x optical zoom and up to 200x zoom with OIS. Then there's a 13 megapixel ultra-wide f2.2 aperture lens. And get this, Huawei has switched to their brand new XMage software algorithm. And this is used for the image processing, making the camera experience even better than when they had the collaboration with Leica from the yesteryears. So I did take some few shots using the P60 Pro. And the main lenses were incredible, especially with the zooming capabilities. Now the 3.5x images and also even up to 10x were incredible. Now even the night shots were amazing, beating out even the Google Pixel 7 Pro's nighttime capabilities. But of course, stay tuned for my in-depth camera review during my full video review of the phone, and subscribe to the channel if you guys haven't done so. Now, if you want to refer to the specs and this entire video on a text format, head on to our website at www.adamlobo.tv or join our legion of tech geeks at our Discord server as well, which I'll link everything at the description below. And of course, let's not forget the front cameras, which has a 13 megapixel f2.4 aperture lens, and the portrait mode shots were surely one of the best in this flagship category with great dynamic range and background to subject blur. Then both the rear and the front camera can record up to 4K 60fps. Yep, Huawei is the only Chinese smartphone maker which has not only rear 4K recording but also for the front as well. Then the other specs of the phone includes having the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 chipset with a 4G modem, so it does not support 5G, so keep that in mind. Then the variant that I have is the 8GB of RAM with 256GB of storage, and it has 4815mAh of battery, where you got options with 66W of wired charging, 50W of wireless charging, and 7.5W of reverse wireless charging for other devices. Now, like the Mate X3, it comes shipped with EMUI version 13.1, which means that you can access all the latest and greatest features from a software perspective. But that is not even the best part. Once again, the Lighthouse app is also available on this particular phone, because as you guys can see that all of the Google apps has been installed on the phone as well, so you can have all this app right at your fingertips. Now, I know you really want to know when exactly these phones are going to be releasing in Malaysia. Well, once again, stay tuned on Adam Lobo TV for you guys to get the update as soon as I get one.